Una katiba mwanzo mpya. Onina haki mwanzo mpya.
Kenya joined the rest of the world in celebrating the first ever International Albinism Awareness Day, which was made possible after ratification by the United Nations General Assembly and slated for June 13th.
As you may be aware, following the UN Human Rights Council Resolution number 23/13 of 13th June 2013 on attacks and discrimination against persons with albinism, and Resolution number 24/33 of 27th September 2013 on technical cooperation for the prevention of attacks against persons with albinism, the United Nations General Assembly adopted the resolution establishing June 13th as an International Albinism Awareness Day.
Themed Nikuna Haki ya Kuishi, the celebration brought leaders and Kenyans from various parts of the country in order to create awareness and advocacy of the condition at a global level, and especially in Africa, where victimization of persons living with albinism is high.
And that is why today we have our theme, which is Nikuna Haki ya Kuishi. Sema hivyo, Nikuna Haki ya Kuishi. This is informed by the reality in Tanzania, where persons with albinism are killed for ritual killing. And amongst us are children that we as a society, and myself as a member of parliament, we have saved. We have Bianca Chacha and Gabriel Kinyanjui. They are now in school. We have taken them from Taita Taveta and Kuria district, and they are now pupils at Thika Primary School for the Blind. These children would have been killed by now. They are 4.5 years old and 5 years. They are all in kindergarten. We need to do more to secure the lives of people with albinism.
Speaking on the historic occasion, Honorable Isaac Mwaura highlighted the milestones gained over the years and promised to continue fighting for more.
We come from far where we were not accepted as people with disabilities. We've come from far to where we are part and parcel of people with disabilities. We come from far where we have a program under the National Council. Today, this day is fully owned by government. Makofi. Now, lakini, the things that affect persons with albinism, and indeed people with disabilities, are many. Still, even when you're in the mainstream, there's a way in which discrimination metamorphoses into something else. We must continue with the agenda of inclusion. On the floor of parliament, in civil society, we must say enough is enough.
Leaders call for an audit of the 300 million Kenyan shillings allocated by the government to persons with disabilities in order to ensure the money is able to assist those able differently in various counties.
And be a national council that let's do a rapid assessment to only select counties and bazaar allocate pesa kwa lemavu. And even if tunaenda kotini tutaenda. Na mimi najua Madam Lichuma hapa anajua kazi. Tutembee pamoja hata tushitaki zile counties ambazo zilokete pesa kwa lemavu ama nini walemavu sini hivyo.
Weighing in the issue, Honorable Sakaja further called for amendments in the Disability Act in order to make buildings accessible to persons with disabilities.
Tuko na sheria mbili ambayo tunaleta katika bunge ya Senate na National Assembly. Ya kwanza ni an overhaul of the Disability Act, kwa sababu tumeona hata kama kuna hiyo sheria ambayo iko, many places, public places, are not well equipped kwa watu ambao ni walemavu. Tuko na mfano katika bunge, kamati ya House Business Committee, mmoja wetu alipata ajali na kaumia, anaitwa Mheshimiwa Denita Gati, sijui kama mnamjua. Do you know, because of a disability, she has never been able to attend a meeting of that committee, kwa sababu hiyo committee iko katika ghorofa la kwanza na hakuna lift kwa bunge ya kitaifa.
Speaking after the ceremony, attendees were happy and for the occasion.
Kama vile nyinyi wote mmeona tumeweza kujienjoy, tukaambiwa mambo mingi. Sasa tukirudi kule, kwa mfano mimi ndio kiongozi wa Makueni County. And we have a group there at Makueni County that is albinism. Makueni County is a group. Sasa tukirudi kule tutaenda tuendelee kuwahimiza, tuendelee kuunganisha wale wenzetu ili tuendelee kuwa kikundi ambacho kimejisimamia,
kwa sababu tuko recognized worldwide and every country is celebrating in the world, so it's a big step forward.
Dr. Choksi was acknowledged for her passionate drive in improving the lives of persons with disability. Speaking after the ceremony, she asked for more to be done, especially in the education sector for persons with albinism.
Albinism is considered more as a social stigma. It is considered as, like a cultural thing. But no, albinism, like any other genetic condition, is a medical condition. And it has to be addressed as a medical condition. And I'm actually appealing to Ministry of Education. I've got another meeting with Ministry of Education. I want to fight for putting in their curriculum that no child with albinism should ever be thrust into blind school. First, let them take to an eye specialist. Let the eye specialist determine that the child's vision is so poor that he has to study.
In a separate venue, Talking Hands Resource Center organized a deaf talent show in a bid to create awareness on sign language and give opportunities for deaf to showcase their talents.
We organized the event to give awareness to the public about sign language and deafness, deaf culture. And this is because our sign language has been enacted in our constitution. Not so many people know anything about sign language. So you'd hear people asking you, what are they doing? Why are they throwing their hands in the air? They'll think that they're mad. Some will think that they're cursed. And many times I'd see most of our communities, our local communities at home, believe like when you give back to a disabled child, you're cursed or something. So we are trying to give awareness to the public to know that deaf people are just like any other person. They can work just like any other person. You've seen acrobats, deaf people doing acrobats. You've seen deaf people dancing. It's only that they can't hear.